Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and welcome to my YouTube channel, Global Health Living. In this video, I'm going to talk about stomach cancer. But before I continue, please subscribe to my channel and be part of the Global Healthy family. So our stomach cancer, or call it gastric cancer, is a kind of cancer that starts inside the stomach or the stomach wall. The 2020 statistics from the World Health Organization show that our stomach cancer is the sixth common cancer we have globally, and it is the fourth common cancer causing death worldwide. So it is really, really a very big problem we have. Most cancers start in the gland cells in the inner stomach lining, and these are called adenocarcinomas. And other stomach cancers start in the wall of the stomach, and these are called gastrointestinal stromal tumors. There is also another kind of stomach cancer that starts in the immune system cells in the stomach, and these are called non-Hodgkin's lymphomas. So what are the signs and symptoms of stomach cancer, or call it gastric cancer? The most common symptom of stomach cancer, or call it gastric cancer, is difficulty swallowing. A person who has developed stomach cancer may feel pain or a burning sensation when swallowing, and they may also feel that the food stuck in the throat or in the chest. So if you have such a problem and it doesn't go away, please go to your doctor. Maybe you have developed a stomach cancer. So the second symptom of stomach cancer is loss of appetite and weight loss. So if you lose weight unintentionally, it may be a sign of advanced stomach cancer. So it is very important to visit your doctor when you lose appetite and you're losing weight unintentionally. The third symptom of stomach cancer is pain in the upper abdomen. If you usually feel pain in the upper abdomen, don't take it for granted. Maybe you are developing stomach cancer. Another symptom of stomach cancer is feeling full after eating a small portion of food. If you feel full every time you eat a small portion of food, please go to the doctor. More so, feeling sick or being sick all the time, please visit your doctor. Another sign of stomach cancer is indigestion. That doesn't go away. And burping. If you feel indigestion for a long time, please go to your doctor. Maybe you are developing a stomach cancer. If you see our blood in your poo, please go to the doctor. Blood in your poo may be caused by something else like hemorrhoids, but still, it can be a sign of stomach cancer. So it is important for you to go to the doctor so that you can be screened. Another sign of stomach cancer is feeling tired and breathless. Breathlessness or feeling tired can be because you have reduced a number of your red blood cells, and then you get such a problem. Other symptoms of stomach cancer include nausea, heartburn, yellowing of the skin, and this can be also with the eyes. Another symptom is vomiting with or without blood, and also a vague discomfort in the abdomen, usually above the navel. So if you're having such symptoms, please go visit your doctor for screening. So what are the causes of stomach cancer? The causes of stomach cancer are not known, but there are risk factors that contribute to the cause of stomach cancer. And these include an infection, for instance, called Helicobacter pylori infection. This infection is caused by bacteria. And this bacteria live in the mucus in the lining of the stomach. Most of the stomach cancers are caused by this kind of infection called Helicobacter pylori infection. There is also another infection that contributes to the cause of stomach cancer, and it is called Epstein-Barr virus infection. And according to the American Cancer Society, around 5 to 10 people with cancer get cancer because of this virus. Another risk factor for stomach cancer is age and gender. Stomach cancer is more in older people, and around half of the stomach cancers develop in people aged 75 or over. Stomach cancers are likely to develop in people who have had part of their stomach removed to treat stomach non-cancerous diseases such as ulcers. So if you have had your part of your stomach removed, please visit your doctor if you experience any of the symptoms that I've mentioned. More so, people who eat salty and smoked food are at risk of getting stomach cancer. A stomach cancer can also develop in people who have stomach polyps called adenomas. So if you have stomach polyps, visit your doctor if you experience more symptoms. So another risk factor of stomach cancer is long-term stomach inflammation. If you have long-term stomach inflammation, or call it gastritis, please visit your doctor in case you have more symptoms. Last but not least is a diet that is low in vegetables and in fruits. If you have such a type of diet, please get to know that you are at a risk of getting stomach cancer. So how can we prevent stomach cancer? Simple routines. Like, for instance, choose a diet full of fruits and vegetables. In this, try to incorporate more fruits and vegetables into your diet each day. By doing that, you are preventing stomach cancer. Secondly, maintain a healthy weight. Please try to work on your weight. If you are obese or overweight, talk to your doctor and find strategies to help you lose weight. More so, reduce on the amount of salty or smoked foods you eat regularly. So protect your stomach by limiting foods that have too much salt. Last but not least, stop smoking and reduce on alcohol use. If you do that, you reduce on the risk of getting stomach cancer. Thank you so much for watching, and please do not forget to subscribe, share this video, like, comment, and tell others about Global Health Family. Thank you.